Well, estate sales, they're also known as yard or tag sales, are a common event in the summertime, but as foreclosures continue to mount in the wake of the mortgage meltdown, is the business of estate sales changing? Well, Stanford Cohen is the proprietor of Estate Sales LA, joins us from Los Angeles. And let's get the terminology going here first, because estate sounds like something large and grand and multi-million, estate sales, how small can they go?
Good morning. How are you, Tom? Estate sales can be anything from, as you say, a very, very large estate to actually somebody that lives in a three-bedroom condominium.
So it's just a matter of something happens, and estates, many people also, I think, assume that the word estate means somebody died. But in my own family, my mother, we needed to get her some assisted care, so we moved her to assisted care, and we had to sell her house. We had an estate sale. So she's still alive and well, but you have things that come along like foreclosures, like moving people to assisted care, that create these estate sales.
Yes, we work with foreclosure. We work with downsizing, people relocating for job purposes. Of course, death is a big part of our business, and yes, foreclosure.
And what is the foreclosure starting? Is the foreclosure business picking up in your business?
I'm getting more and more inquiries via email, via phone calls, and yes, we've had foreclosure sales.
And yet, you're in Beverly Hills, so I guess Beverly Hills isn't exempt from people overbuying either.
That is correct, what you're saying, yes.
Yeah. So how does this work? So an estate sale, I've found that people always think that their possessions are worth more than anybody else thinks they're worth. Is that a fair statement?
That is a very, very fair statement. Usually if you inherit something from your mother, your grandmother, you think that what your family member has is worth $1 million. And sentimentally, it is worth $1 million to you. But on the fair market, it's not worth exactly what you think it's worth. In a real world, let's just say hypothetically, your furniture was bought at Sloan's and you paid $1,000 for a particular sofa. You would really expect to get, in a real world, somewhere in the range of $330 to $365, depending upon the condition of the particular item.
So part of your job then is to kind of bring a little reality check to what things are worth.
That is correct.
You must have to put your salesman's hat on to convince the people that no, this really isn't worth $1,000. When somebody comes in, though, I mean, who are the people that are coming around to these estate sales? I would think that there's some experts out there that are looking for somebody who doesn't know what things are worth and buy them on the cheap.
We do. We have people like you, Tom. People like myself. People that are collectors, interior decorators, designers, architects. We being in California, we have a lot of set decorators. We're members of an association that brings a lot of people into our sales. Period pieces. If a TV show is going to be going on the air for the 1950s, they're going to come and look for an old 1950s television set. We have vintage clothing. We have jewelry. It's an array of things that you can buy in an estate sale.
Hollywood gets their old TV sets. We have to leave
actually
it there. Go ahead.
That's where a lot of Hollywood does get their props, is from companies like mine.
That's fascinating. Hey, Stanford Cohen, Estate Sales, Los Angeles, thank you very much for being on the program today.